Hey guys, what's up? Blacker Bricks here, back with another video for News Thursdays. Now we have quite a bit of LEGO news this week, and I'll start off with one of many LEGO Ideas projects that has received 10,000 supporters in just the recent couple weeks. So this one, the first one is the Truly. So as you can see it now with interiors, and it just got 10,000 supporters, so congratulations to that creator. So this is a bit of unfortunate news for at least those of you living in the United States. We heard that the LEGO Ninjago hype clothes are actually not coming to the United States as of now. So this is just as of now. We don't know in the future what might happen, but it is a little bit unfortunate to hear. So this is actually a bit of LEGO video news. So apparently they actually signed a record label, this Neyo, not sure how he pronounces that, and they actually released a music video for that. So if you search up Shake and these two names, you'll actually see a music video. I would have played it, but I don't want to get my video copyright struck before that has happened in the past, so I don't want to repeat that mistake. Anyways, here is actually the LEGO March 2021 calendar. So I'll just go over it. I think I actually have two pages. This is just a sort of close-up. So at the top, we have obviously video. They're really promoting this quite a bit, as you saw back here with the new music video. So they're really pushing this because I think this is being released on the 1st of March, so not that far from now, actually. We have the free exclusive Amelia Earhart tribute with purchases over 100. You can see that right over here with the same... Well, it's actually not the same. So it looks like it has Amelia Earhart's face on it, but it's a similar sort of seal as the one on the Charles Dickens set. We also have the free Easter Bunny carrot house, and I'll be honest, when I first saw this, for some reason, I remembered SpongeBob, his pineapple house. I don't know why that is. Maybe it's because the way it's shaped, it just doesn't look like a carrot to me, to be honest. Let me know what you guys think. I understand that it's tough to design well at that scale. I have had a lot of experience, and it's cool. It's available on orders over 60 from the 15th to April 5th, so March 15th to April 5th. Okay. So here we have a little bit more stuff. Sorry, it's really big. So we have just some stuff. Love building. You'll love building LEGO rewards. So I don't think there's anything special. We have International Women's Day on March 8th. We have in-store only offer. Let's see, purchases over 50, and that is so small. 315 to 405. So I think that this one, the Easter chick and the Easter bunny, run at the same time. So that's pretty cool. Looks like we have a little mystery. Don't know what that's supposed to be hinting at. So the LEGO Monkey Kid sets have been listed on the LEGO shop. They are not available for sale yet, but you can take a look at them. And I just realized, sorry about that, poor quality cropping there. The LEGO Jazz Quartet, previously a submission to, I believe, a music competition on LEGO Ideas, has actually received 10,000 supporters. I did support this, and I think this is a wonderfully, wonderfully put together, wonderfully put together set. I am honestly not sure why they use that 2x4 tile, I think, from the LEGO Movie 2. Not 100% sure why, but it's so well done. The people and the instruments and they're just the positions. It's so realistic, so lifelike. Really, really well done on this. I hope this gets to see the light of day and turns into a real set. So once again, we have this. I guess this is just a little bit of a closer look, right? Because this was sort of far away. We can take a look. So it has that little rabbit. Looks like they use a quarter tile for his nose. I think they are maybe showing what's going on in the back. Some, I have to be honest, I don't know if those are supposed to be flowers or eggs. I honestly don't know. Maybe they're flowers, maybe they're eggs. The carrot, I mean, looking at it closer, it is a little bit, it's nice. It's cool. I'm not the biggest fan. I think those are actually stickers trying to show the pattern of the carrot. So that's cool. I don't know. I just don't see it as a carrot immediately. And so it looks like we have another one of the seals up there. Anyways, the Razor Crest, I'm sure many of you guys know about this, from The Mandalorian, is now available on Amazon. So I'll be dropping a link to that. Unfortunately, it isn't on any sale. It's really just available at retail. I'm not sure if it's available on the LEGO website, though. So if you want to pick this up and support the channel, there's a link down below. So LEGO actually released something else on the on their Spotify. So this was something I talked about a while ago, the LEGO White Noise, And yeah, I just realized this picture is not the best quality, but it's really cool actually. So it's pretty much Lego pieces and pages flipping. So it's pretty neat. And they actually released a video here, showing you exactly how they made it. So I'll just play a little bit of that. All right, sorry about that, guys. Kind of cut out. So the audio I'm using right now is actually coming from headphones, and I unplugged it to show you the video. So I mean, I can just show you. I can't play the audio, unfortunately. But what they're showing is just the process of how they recorded. So they poured out some Lego bricks. Let me see if I actually.
Recognized by generations all over the world. The sound Lego bricks make is also incredibly soothing. Given the year we've all had, soothing is something we need now more than ever.
I thought that was a really cool video they put together. So, so very, very cool work on that. Thank you. This is another set that has made it to 10,000. Very, very cool, actually. I feel like something like this has been made. I think I was spirited away. So not my Lego Totoro, but perhaps this one as well. This is, I believe, a Studio Ghibli or Ghibli, based on that animated film. I haven't watched it. I do wish to in the future, but it looks like a very, very well done set. Quite cute. And I really do hope something like this gets made. I know it's a bit different from what we usually see from Lego ideas, but it would be very cool. I think something like this would do well. So here we actually have a closer look at some of the video characters. This one is sort of crazy. I think this is, I don't know the exact name. I think this is the alien keytarist. And that's actually the keytar piece we got from the, oh my God, what am I trying to say? The Series 20 minifigures. Now I have to think, I have a feeling that the keys on the keytarist were reversed, so the black keys were towards him in this picture. So I think they might have actually switched that. I'll have to double check, but it's the same piece, just dark turquoise instead of red. And you can see there are a couple more tiles. They actually have released a lot of these pictures. I'm just showing you three. We have, I think, the singing banshee, perhaps, and they have some cool tiles, so relating, I guess, to their theme. And finally, we have, I think, Disco Rabbit. I don't know, these head molds are really crazy, so I'm kind of interested to see how people might use these in customs. And yeah, so again, we have a better look now at the Amelia Earhart tribute set. No piece count, actually, so this might be a European picture. And I like the base. I know it's a little bit simple, but it works completely fine. Very cool minifigure as well. I feel like that's just like the Charles Dickens figure is going to be very, very valuable in the future. And a pretty cool set in general. Nice use of the paddle or the kayaks. So this is online Lego Pick-A-Brick. I am sure you guys are familiar. If not, really, what it is there are actually two places you can buy bricks on the Lego website. There is the Bricks and Pieces, which is the same place where you get the replacement parts and broken bricks. And with that, they have a huge, huge selection. So you pretty much search a set number and then you can find pieces, or you can just search a part number. Now, the thing is, you can only get 200 pieces and the prices tend to be a bit higher. Now, Pick-A-Brick is actually, you can just search up Lego Pick-A-Brick and this website should probably come up. Unfortunately, this is only available in a couple countries, just like all of the other Lego products. But the interesting thing is, the prices here are cheaper, but and you can also buy almost like 1,000, right? So I think the max is about 999, and they have a huge, huge selection, so you can buy a lot of different pieces. Oh, all right, sorry, I misspoke. So unfortunately, unlike the bricks and pieces, which I talked about earlier, this one, Pick-A-Brick, right? This one does not have a huge selection, so I think they have about 1,400 for, which is still pretty great, but not compared to the bricks and pieces, which is huge. Anyways, the news is that they are actually testing out a minimum, so not a maximum, but rather a minimum. So similar to the Lego Pick-A-Brick wall, you have to spend at least, I think it was 11.99 pounds. I might be wrong with that number. I did read this a while ago, so correct me if I'm wrong, but they're just testing that out. So I'd be interested to see that. I don't know what to think about this news. I feel that these pieces are usually shipped the same way as other sets. So they have free shipping over 35. So usually I would never place an order on this under 35, but I can see that other people might be a little bit disappointed that you can't just pick up a couple pieces. We'll see how it goes. Another set, I think this is the Map of Middle Earth. And very, very cool looking build. Super, super detailed. I love just the way it's done. Like, I don't know if I could ever design something like this. They have some water, some very cool wedge plates, some different towers, and a recognizable landscape and little features from the movies and books. So now, LEGO Technic, they actually have a poll, I believe, on the LEGO Ideas or the LEGO website. They're asking fans, what would you like to see from LEGO Technic, excuse me, in the future? So you can definitely fill that out. I'll try and leave a link to that as well, in addition to the Mandalorian link. And so I'm sure some of you guys might know or remember this. It's actually, I think it's about 10 years old now, so 2011 or so. This was a LEGO Universe, massively multiplayer online game. So the original game soundtrack, I think that was by Brian Taylor. They're actually remastering and releasing it. So they haven't released it yet, but there are plans for that, and I think that is really cool. I'll be honest with you, I haven't played this game and I don't know what the soundtrack is, but I am glad to see that LEGO, it feels like LEGO's really embracing a lot of its history with the old sets coming back with the LEGO Ideas fan vote, this remastering. So it's good that they're doing lots of cool stuff like that. Another LEGO Ideas set, and I know this is crazy because there's so many sets being approved recently. Sorry, not approved, reaching 10,000 supporters. This is the Marine Life. Very, very creative and well done. So I think what they actually are trying to go for is sort of a, I guess, a little aquarium or super small terrarium. I see the poor seahorse looks like he's really stuck in there. So we have a seahorse, jellyfish, and clownfish. All three of them brilliantly done. Really, really well done. I don't think it would be tough to do these better at this scale. I think they did a really good job, and I'm quite inspired by this. Maybe go ahead and, if not make marine life, maybe some animal life in LEGO. So here we have the LEGO Adidas clothing. I think they're working with Ninjago and Dots, I believe. So they're making more clothing. I think that is these two clothes are supposed to be Ninjago related. Seems like that to me. And finally, this is our last piece of news today. The VIA or VIA Rail Canada set has reached 10,000 supporters on LEGO Ideas. Very well designed set, and I love the background. It's so well like integrated or put into that set. It looks really good. And yeah, thanks again for checking this video out. I really do appreciate all the support from you guys, and I'll see you guys soon. Thanks again, and have a great day.